In the world of the Linux distro, it's pretty common to have an LTS release available. Ubuntu is a very common example. And most distros out there have KDE Plasma available in some form. Maybe it's a bit out of date, maybe it's not pre-installed, but it's usually available. So, were you even aware that Plasma had an LTS offering available? I say had for two reasons. Firstly, back in 5.27, they absolutely had one available. 5.27 LTS, if we go back to the older releases, 5.24 LTS, 5.18 LTS, 5.12 LTS, 5.8 LTS, and that was the first of the 5 series. And even before the recent news, if we look at the Plasma 6 series, there is a section here on LTS releases. No scheduled LTS releases yet. If distributions find LTS releases useful, we will schedule those in close cooperation with those corresponding distributions. So, for over a year now, there just hasn't been an LTS release on the current version of Plasma. And it's not like nobody was using it. Most people weren't using it, but some people were. Both OpenSUSE Leap and Kubuntu LTS both have made use of the Plasma LTS offering. But the LTS offering has never been good. It kind of just was there. It existed because it kind of made sense to have something LTS. And in a recent post from Nate Graham over on his blog, Notes from the Graz Plasma Sprint, there is this section here on the Plasma LTS, basically outlining what is very likely going to happen to it. The TLDR, as you can probably tell from the fact that there hasn't been a single LTS release so far, is, it's dead, basically. This is pretty much it. It's done, it's dead, it already was dead, but let's make it official. It's no secret that our Plasma LTS long-term support product isn't great. It really only means we backport bug fixes for longer than usual, usually without even testing them. So, basically, you think you're getting this slow-moving, well-tested LTS branch, which is what you would expect from something like, say, Ubuntu LTS, the LTS kernel, things like that. But really what you're getting is the thing that no Plasma developers enjoy actually working on and enjoy testing. So it's this like half thrown together thing, which is fine most of the time, but no one really cares to properly make it an LTS. And I get it, right? Like, you want to work on the cool new Plasma things. You don't want to worry about supporting the old Plasma things. So the core function that you'd expect from an LTS is not being fulfilled by Plasma LTS. Basically, you have to ask the question, why are we even offering it in the first place? If it's not doing it correctly, and nobody wants to do it correctly, why is it here? On that note, there's no corresponding LTS product for frameworks or gear apps, leaving a lot of holes in the LTS umbrella. Frameworks is the KDE libraries, gear are the KDE apps. So the only thing actually covered by Plasma LTS is the Plasma part of it, the desktop part of it, which, if you ask me, is probably the least important thing I'd want from an LTS. If I'm using an LTS setup, I want to have stable libraries. I want to have stable applications. If my desktop is updating, maybe for some people that's important, but it's definitely on the bottom of the list. Then there's the fact that LTS means different things to different people. Many have an expansive definition of the term that gives them expectations of stability that are impossible to meet. So I would say even on that bare minimum expectation, if you hear about Plasma LTS, I would reasonably expect that the entirety of that Plasma version, the frameworks and the gear included, would be part of the LTS. Like, just that by itself, it doesn't achieve. Going past, you know, the whole Ubuntu LTS, where they support it for many years into the future, I don't know an LTS definition this would meet, that wouldn't just be covered by saying you have a longer support window on a regular release. And considering that nobody really cared that it was gone for over a year, like, if you can fulfill all of your goals without using it, again, like, why is it here? Our conclusion was that the fairly limited nature of the product isn't meeting anyone's expectations, so we decided to not continue it. It already basically wasn't being continued, now it's just officially not being continued. Instead, though, we'll lengthen the effective support period of normal Plasma releases a bit by adding on an extra bug fix release, taking us from 5 to 6. So basically taking the regular releases and then supporting those just a little bit longer, as those are the ones that people are actually using. We also revisited the topic of reducing from 3 to 2 Plasma feature releases per year with a much longer bug fix release schedule. It would effectively make every Plasma version a sort of mini LTS, and we'd also like to try to align them with the twice yearly release schedules of Kubuntu and Fedora. So basically, each release is going to be the main release for longer, so effectively, you're also supporting it for longer as there's more time until the next version comes out, right? If that makes sense. So, again, this is the version that people are using. I don't really see a negative to this when it comes to support. I do think there is a problem with having to wait for really important features a little bit longer. Feature additions are going to be slower, but each release, because they take longer, should theoretically have more in them, which also creates a problem of potentially being buggier as you need longer testing cycles. So I do hope they keep the testing cycle thing in mind and possibly run longer beta periods as well. This model doesn't fully replace a proper LTS cycle, but they never had a proper LTS cycle anyway. So going from the half LTS to now longer supports on regular releases, frankly, I think it's just an all-round upgrade. For some background, last Academy we decided to postpone making the schedule change until all the KDE items on the Wayland Known Significant Issues wiki page are addressed. During the sprint, we took another look and found the list much shorter than it was last year, with most remaining items in progress or nearing completion. So we agreed to revisit the topic again this year's Academy in about 4 months. So this is the page being talked about here. I've discussed this with Nate multiple times. Basically, the idea is these aren't things which are generally nice to haves, right? Like, there's going to be nice to haves that you always want added to the Wayland side. These are things which limit basic core functionality or stop certain people even being able to use the system. You know, accessibility features, having basic application features simply not working. Of course, if you're a graphics artist, there is definitely a lot of things which are not up to scratch on the Wayland side. And of course, if there are things like major performance regressions where you just cannot use the Wayland side on certain hardware configurations. Now, unlike the GNOME side, KDE isn't planning to drop the X11 session anytime soon. It will happen at some point in the future. Don't get me wrong, they also want to get rid of it. They also don't test it that much. They also don't want to work on it. But they're willing to keep things around a bit longer until they're absolutely certain that things are going to be ready for basically everyone. As always, there's going to be somebody left at the end where their hyper niche use case that relies on something developed 40 years ago and no one's touched the code base in 20 years, you know, those people are always going to have trouble moving along. But if we can deal with like 99.9% of people, you know, that's a good thing. I hope that by then, Academy 2025, we've either got everything done or can consider it close enough that we pull the trigger on the new schedule anyway, the latter outcome being what we did for the Wayland by default rollout. So this would be the new release schedule, so they get features out a little bit slower. I would say it's probably a good idea to do that, right? Like, it hasn't really hurt GNOME for its entire life to have that model. Most of its life, I don't know if it's entire life, most of its life to have that model. So if it makes things easier for distro developers, it's probably a good thing to make sure that, you know, Kubuntu can actually get an up-to-date version of Plasma available rather than shipping like two or three versions behind. However, the concept of long-term support doesn't go away just because we're not giving that label to any of our software releases anymore. Really, it was always a label applied by distros anyway. I guess you could say that? Like, the project was calling it LTS, but sure, I guess we can go with that. The distro's doing the hard work of building an LTS final product out of myriad software components that were never themselves declared LTS by their own developers. It's a lot of work. I will say this, there are a lot of cases where, well, most of the software on an LTS system is not going to be LTS by the upstream project. Things like the kernel, maybe the browser, and that's probably most of it, maybe some libraries here and there, but like most of the software in your system, upstream's not doing LTS for it. So we decided to strengthen our messaging that users of KDE software and LTS distros should be reporting issues to their distro and not to KDE. Now, this is a great goal to have. I understand this, Nate. Users are stupid. Like, you might not say it because you're nice, but users are stupid. And if they see they're running KDE, a lot of people don't really know what they're entirely running. And we'll go to the thing that looks like the place they have to report it to. So even if you don't want them to come to you with reports about LTS problems, there's still going to be some of them that do it. An LTS software stack is complex and requires a lot of engineering effort to stabilize. The most appropriate people to triage issues on LTS distros are the engineers putting them together. Absolutely agreed, it's just people will go to the wrong places with their bug reports. This will free up time on KDE's bug triages and developers to focus on current issues they can reproduce and fix. I will say it will probably slow down people, but it's not going to stop it. Rather than wasting time on issues that can't be reproduced due to a hugely different software stack or that were fixed months or year ago, reported to us anyway due to many users' unfamiliarity with software releases and bug reporting. This right here is another problem where these LTS distros will cherry pick patches. And in an LTS distro, you kind of have to do that if there isn't an LTS offering of the software. But by cherry picking patches, you have this mismatch of different patches where it might not really be possible to replicate the problem in the upstream version of the project. Great example of this is GNOME on Ubuntu. Ubuntu GNOME is not GNOME. It's really like a soft fork of GNOME. If Plasma LTS was more akin to something like Ubuntu LTS, the LTS kernel, things like that, and was actually, you know, actively used by projects that are offering Plasma, yeah, it would make a lot more sense to keep this around and make the project, you know, more and more useful. Since that's not what it was, and it was just a very limited LTS, and it was basically on life support anyway since the start of Plasma 6, frankly, it's probably a good thing just to get rid of it now and make it clear that we're done with this. Like, it's not that there's going to be an LTS release eventually. We're just not going to do it. So if you're expecting one, work with us and we can deal with something that best suits what you're trying to do. So let me know, have you used Plasma LTS in the past? I actually would like to know because, as I said, not many people really use it. You don't really go out of your way to choose Plasma LTS. If you're on it, it's on the very few things that happen to be using it. So anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Bear Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and Plasma is the fourth state of matter. We'll be right back. something like this.